Okay, I let my bread maker do all the work when it comes to making my dough for pizza. I'm just letting it rise a little more. The cycle is done, and pretty soon we'll get started with making pizza. Okay, I just got finished using this tart shaper to kind of grind up the seasonings in this bowl for a mortar and pestle effect that helps to release the oils and the dry herbs. I'm going to pour 1 8-ounce can of tomato sauce, cost me a quarter. I want to also pour in a portion of prepared spaghetti sauce. I'm just going to use that jar, I'm sorry, the can to measure. I have an additional cup of sauce. We like a lot of sauce on our pizza. I'm going to press a garlic clove and mix this up and set it to the side. Okay, I've taken out one of my paper chef baking stones. It's a pie plate. This is going to be a kind of deep dish pizza. And I've also put out a silicone mat and I put a little flour on it. So I just need to turn out my dough and separate it. Okay, so I use my kitchen scraper to cut my dough. And I just cut off about 1/4 of what was prepared. And I'm just rolling it out on the mat. I think it's better for me to do these during the daytime because we lose so much light at night. I don't know what's going on. I told you guys before, my kitchen is booty and electrical problems seem to be contributing to the lack of light. So anyway, the what is it called? The pie plate is 10 inches and this particular silicone mat has a little guide so I can roll it out to 10 inches or whatever size I choose. Okay, I'm just going to transplant this to the stone. I don't know if I mentioned before that I put a little cornmeal in the bottom of my stone so that the dough won't adhere and it'll come off easily. Okay, next I'm going to use my tool, I forget what it's called right now, to make a few little perforations in the dough, not going all the way down to the stone. I forget what this tool is called, but it's a paper chef tool. It used to be like $3.50. I use it when I make baked potatoes and stuff like that. Alright, that just keeps the dough from puffing up in the middle. Now I want to add some sauce. We like a lot of sauce in our house. And ordinarily, we could spend about $30 in pizza and stuff from Pizza Hut. But I can make 5 individual pizzas for everyone in the home for less than $5. It's all about saving money and having fun too. The kids like to dress and top their own pizzas. Okay, so that's the sauce. I'll be back with cheese and tacos. Okay, so I grated my own mozzarella cheese. It's just an 8-ounce brick. I probably won't need the entire thing for this. Just want to spread that out a little. And this is just going to be a pepperoni pizza, but you can do all kinds of pizzas. This just happens to be what I'm making today. You can do veggies only. You can do chopped Italian sausage. And what's cool about it is you're controlling the amount of fat, salt, and or preservatives in your own pizza. Alright, yes, I know we need to get away from processed meats. Nothing wrong with a little pepperoni every now and then. They have turkey pepperoni now too, guys. Alright. So that's it. I'm going to put it in the oven. Okay, so it's not so great to put a cold pizza in a cold oven. You want to preheat the oven. I'm going to put mine on 350. And you only need to cook the pizza for about 8 to 10 minutes. Okay, things are coming up pretty well with this pizza. It only has about 2 minutes left and it's looking good. And of course I have another one ready to go into the oven. I have much larger stones, but my oven does not work, my wall oven, so I'm using a countertop oven. Just goes to show, if you have a passion for cooking, nothing will stop you from making what you want to. Okay, so it's done. Gonna take it and put it on the cooling rack, and then I have more pizzas to finish. Alright, thanks for watching. Please rate, comment, and subscribe.